The Philippines records the highest shopping scam rate out of the 11 economies surveyed in the Asia Scam Report this year. But experts fear the number may still rise as more people shop online this holiday season. Jackie Pascual with details.
The Philippines scores big, unfortunately, in the latest Asia Scam Report 2023. Among 11 nations surveyed, the country ranked number one in terms of shopping scam rate. Aside from shopping scams, the Philippines also has a high rate in investment scams, lottery scams, job scams, and identity theft. The Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center is alarmed by this information, especially with more Filipinos using the internet for commerce and other activities.
Marami talaga manggagancho na nakakarga sa mga social media platforms. Mag-ingat-ingat to. Lalo-lalo na yung may mga links minsan pinapadala sa ating cellphone. Hindi ho ganun ang sistema.
The group ScamWatch Pilipinas warns the number of fraudulent schemes may rise further due to the holiday season.
Mga scammers dito sa atin, alam naman nila na pumapasok na yung mga bonus, maraming pera yung mga tao.
They urge the public to be extra careful when buying from social media sites. They also listed some red flags that the online transaction could be a scam.
Una-una, sobrang mura. Pangalawa, wala siya sa social media. Wala siya sa registered platforms, no? Pangatlo rito, gumagamit ng malalaking endorser. Hindi totoo yun.
Alam mo namang mahal yung item, tapos sobrang mura, too good to be true. And then titingnan nyo yung store, kung yung store ay legitimate ba yung pangalan. Mag-ingat din sa tinatawag na delivery scam.
CICC also urges the public to report any scams to hotline 1326. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
About 300 million pesos worth of alleged counterfeit cigarettes seized by authorities during a raid in Batangas. Dennis Dato has more.
Police bust an illegal cigarette factory at abandoned resort spa in Agoncillo, Batangas. 34 people were arrested, including 6 Chinese nationals. Authorities say the group's operations began June of this year.
Medyo liblib na ito, no? Walang mag-aakala na merong gumagawa ng mga peking sigarilyo. Yung iba, kung makikita nyo, wala pa itong level, no? So pagdating ito sa point of destination nila, no, nilalagyan nila ito ng markings and nilalagay nila sa isang kahon na ang nakalagay dun sa kahon na yon ay brand ng isang kilalang sigarilyo.
To avoid suspicion, they did not connect to the electricity grid and instead used generators.
Kasi malalaman kasi ang ano nito, yung billing. Kasi declare nga to na ano eh, yung non-operational resort eh. Nung sa pandemic. Kaya nagawa sila.
A total of 672 boxes of counterfeit cigarettes were confiscated. The seized cigarettes, along with the machines used to produce them, have an estimated value of 300 million pesos. According to the PNP, the government is losing a significant amount of tax revenue due to the counterfeit cigarettes. The suspects allegedly use fake documentary stamps from other countries to evade taxes.
Yung documentary stamp po na nakita namin dyan ay from foreign country from the Philippines.
Billion-billion yung nawawalang taxes na dapat sana ibayad natin sa gobyerno, no? Yun yung una. And of course, yung mga naninigarilyo, no? Baka naman itong produkto nila is hazardous, no? Or mas malala pa yung idudulot na sakit dun sa mga maninigarilyo nitong produkto na ito.
The suspects will be facing charges for violating the National Internal Revenue Code of the Philippines, specifically cigarette smuggling. Authorities say they learned about the illegal factory after receiving tips about suspicious activities at the closed resort spa, including the arrival of Chinese nationals in the area. Authorities also discovered a warehouse full of Finnish counterfeit cigarette products ready for distribution to stores at a warehouse in the village of Pansipit, also in the town of Agoncillo. Police are also looking into the possible liability of the resort owner. Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News, Agoncillo, Batangas.
Philippine officials maintain the recent transport strike failed to freeze the country's public transportation system. Andrea Taguines has that story.
5 days and two transport strikes later, the Philippine government maintains there was hardly any impact on the country's public transportation system. Transport group Piston stopped plying their routes from Monday to Wednesday, while Manibela followed suit by holding its own transport strike Wednesday to Friday. Piston and Manibela are protesting the December 31 franchise consolidation deadline as part of the public utility vehicle modernization program. They fear that joining cooperatives will only favor bigger players and that it would still not be enough to help them pay off the cost of upgrading to modern jeepneys.
Maraming co-op na mga chairman na nagre-reklamo na dahil hindi makabayad. Kaya nga kumare, ayaw na rin namin sumali doon dyan dahil isa rin kami sa hindi makakabayad.
The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board and the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority prepared to ferry stranded passengers. But according to both agencies, only about 10% of the vehicles they deployed were put to use.
Masasabi ko po rin na wala pong epekto yung idineclare na bagong grupo na ito sa na strike. Dahil po kahapon at hanggang kaninang umaga, wala po kaming na-deploy na libreng sakay. Masasabi ko po na matagumpay po yung paghahanda ng pamahalaan dito sa strike.
Some commuters also did not find it hard to get a ride.
Napansin ko naman po, okay naman po kasi hindi naman po lahat nag-strike. Yung iba naman po ay bumibiyahe pa rin.
Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista has said the consolidation process is non-negotiable. In response, Manibela is now threatening to quit plying their routes completely.
Parang wala na rin kaming ididemand siguro sa gobyerno. Taposin na lang namin itong strike na yon. Tapos garahin na talaga kami. Ayaw na namin. Parang nung panahon po ng pandemic ay naghanap na lang po ng ibang kakakitaan siguro para wala na po kaming kaaway o tagtag kami sa gobyerno na pabigat sa kanila at maging umasa na lang siguro sa kanila.
But the LCFRB isn't too concerned. It also says that its doors will remain open for transport groups who would be willing to keep engaging with the government to learn more about the PUV modernization process.
Hindi po makakaapekto sa supply ng public transport po natin ang naging anunsyo po ng Manibela. Pero maghahanda pa din po tayo. Hindi naman din po namin gugustuhin, hindi na mamasada ang mga tsuper po na ito dahil lang po sa simpleng hindi po nila pa naiintindihan ng PUVMP. Kaya po kami po mismo ang makikiusap, bigyan nyo po ng pagkakataon ang PUVMP.
The LTFRB chief even promised to find more ways to help jeepney drivers.
Perhaps we can have what we call a joint ownership between the driver, the owner, and the cooperative.
The so-called Magnificent Seven, which consists of other major transport groups in the country, also reiterating its support for the government. In a joint statement, it encouraged Manibela and Piston to continue their dialogue with transport officials, saying it's the only way to achieve a just transition for all stakeholders. Meanwhile, the LTFRB has now issued show cause orders to not less than 17 Manibela jeepney drivers and operators who took part in previous transport strikes. Proof, it says, that joining such movements have its consequences. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
After four straight weeks of rollbacks, pump prices are heading higher next week. Estimates show diesel and kerosene prices might increase by as much as 50 centavos per liter. As for gasoline, prices may see no change or go up by at least 30 centavos per liter. Almost 400,000 deaths in Europe in 2021 found to be related to air pollutants. A report by the European Environment Agency said some of these deaths could have been avoided if pollutants were reduced to recommended levels. The highest number of deaths occurred in Poland, Italy, and Germany, while those in Northern Europe, which is Iceland or Estonia, saw the lowest. The release of the report comes ahead of the UN Climate Summit in Dubai, happening next week. There, the governments and international organizations will try to accelerate action to curb global warming, mainly caused by the burning of coal that also releases pollutants in the air. The Philippine Justice Chief says Manila's comeback to the fold of the International Criminal Court needs serious study. This remark came after Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said on Friday a possible return to the ICC is being studied. For Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, hasty decisions on the matter will put the country's reputation at risk. This as he appears doubtful the government will really cooperate with the ICC on its probe into the Duterte administration's drug war.
Pag-aralan natin to bilang isang bansa. We are better than that to just jump into the fray because somebody said we should.
Remulla's been vocal about his stance that the international body has no jurisdiction over the Philippines. A Philippine lawmaker belied claims Speaker Martin Romualdez is the brain behind House resolutions urging the government to cooperate with the ICC. House Majority Leader Manuel Dalipe says the resolutions are being treated the same way as other measures subject to customary legislative procedures. Dalipe also denies the lower chamber's move is a personal attack against former President Rodrigo Duterte.
Hindi po totoo na pinipilit or may instruction si Speaker Ferdinand Romualdez na i-priority yung House resolution. Kung ipra-priority po yan, dapat nagbigay siya ng approval for being it a priority measure. Pero wala pong pinirmahan na si Speaker Romualdez. Yung resolution naman, if you look at the resolution, it was not meant to be anti-Duterte. Lahat naman na kasi ng kongresista na gusto maghain ng resolution, we have to hear it. It was not meant to be anti-Duterte. Lahat naman na kasi ng kongresista na gusto maghain ng resolution, we have to hear it. It will pass. We are in a democratic legislative process. Pangit naman po pag may naghain ng resolusyon. May hinain na resolusyon ang isang kongresista tapos hindi natin bibigyan ng regular process, legislative process. So it will undergo. It so happened.
President Marcos vows to boost the Scout Rangers' resources and training to enhance the Philippines' defense forces. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo joins us on the line for more details on this story. Hi, Kat.
Hi, Stanley. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said the national government is reviewing the capability requirements of the Scout Rangers Regiment so that necessary resources and support can be provided for one of the Philippine Army's specialized units. The Department of National Defense has been tasked to review the Scout Rangers' capability requirements and pursue options that will enhance their operational capabilities and effectiveness to achieve the desired defense offensive. By the desired defense offensive, the president means that he plans to provide the necessary resources and support that will enable the Scout Rangers, including our special forces units, to support the armed forces as it transforms into a stronger and more reliable defense force capable of defending the country against current and emerging threats. The president also said that the specialized skills in warfare, counterterrorism, and special operations make the Scout Rangers indispensable to our nation's security. That is why there is a need to bolster their capabilities alongside the country's external defense. Now, Stanley, while the Philippines is beefing up the country's defense capabilities, the president also said that the government still needs to address the pressing national concern, which is the pursuit of lasting peace. During his speech at the 73rd founding anniversary of the 1st Scout Rangers Regiment, the president mentioned the Executive Order Number 47, wherein certain amnesty proclamations have been issued to rebels. The president said that by providing a path for former rebels to return to the fold of the law, the National Amnesty Program contributes to the overall stability and unity in the country. Now, Marcos Jr., who also trained as a Scout Ranger, ended his speech by acknowledging Scout Rangers who showed exemplary performance in their duties, as well as those who continue to exemplify bravery, dedication, excellence, professionalism, and courage in their mission of safeguarding and developing our nation. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Kat. Now, two resolutions addressing South China Sea issues failed to get the consensus of Asia-Pacific lawmakers meeting in Manila. Now, China put up resistance to the resolutions while denouncing joint Philippine-U.S. patrols in the West Philippine Sea. Sherian Torres reports.
Two resolutions introduced at the 31st Asia-Pacific Parliamentarians Forum seeking to promote regional peace and stability in the South China Sea failed to get off the ground. Philippine Senator Ronald De La Rosa, chairman of the Political and Security Matters plenary session, says the Chinese delegation opposed many provisions in the draft resolutions submitted by the Philippines and Indonesia. De La Rosa adds the Chinese side proposed discussing the issue through bilateral talks, which means a one-on-one with the Asian giant.
According to our rules, there should be a consensus. So meaning, kung meron mang may comment, mayroong reservation, or mayroong opposition towards a certain draft resolution, ay talagang may babasura yung draft resolution mo. Nag-upo ang China. So we have to follow the rules.
The resolution by the Philippines and Indonesia underscores their growing concern over what they call as widening geopolitical polarities and sharpening strategic competition that threaten international peace and security. Indonesia also asked parliamentarians to respect the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, or UNCLOS. According to Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, a similar resolution was filed by Japan, Mexico, and Australia. During Friday's session, Senator Jingo Estrada expressed the Philippine stand amid the ongoing tension in the West Philippine Sea.
Let us be clear. The concerns we express are not intended to assign blame or take sides. Instead, they reflect our shared commitment upholding a rules-based international order. It is through these rules that we can navigate the complexities of competing claims and interests in a manner that fosters understanding and preserves regional stability.
In the meantime, Chinese parliamentarian Bo Zeng delivered the message of their 15-man delegation in Chinese, but journalists were not provided a copy of translated speech. 275 lawmakers attended the gathering. The forum comes as the Philippines and the United States conclude their joint patrols in the West Philippine Sea. Defense Secretary Gilbert Chadoro says similar drills will be held in the future. He likewise disputed China's claims that the Philippines has enlisted foreign forces to patrol the sea.
Sino bang nananakop, sino ba ang kumukupkop sa South China Sea, no? Sa West Philippine Sea, lalo na. It is China. The Philippines is not stirring up trouble. This is the reverse of the truth. It's an absolute falsity for China to say that. And it is once again reversing the truth, consistent with its narrative. The Philippines is not stirring up trouble.
National Security Advisor Eduardo Año also rejects China's assertion Manila has tapped foreign forces to patrol the South China Sea. Año insists the Philippines has the inherent and sovereign right to conduct patrols with its allies and friends to ensure the security and stability of the region. Año adds the joint patrols were conducted well within the country's exclusive economic zone. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.